வந்தே சிந்து மாபதிம் சுரகுரும் வந்தே ஜெகத் காரணம் வந்தே பன்னக பூஷணம் சசிதரம் வந்தே பசூனாம் பதிம் வந்தே சூரிய சசாங்க வன்னிநயனம் வந்தே முகுந்த பிரியம் வந்தே பக்த ஜன ஆஸ்ரயம் ச வரதம் வந்தே பக்த ஜன ஆஸ்ரயம் ச வரதம் வந்தே சிவம் சங்கரம். Friends, Sri Krishna is Yogeshwara. This Sri Krishna, the God of gods, has a desire for butter. It is traditionally described that Krishna is fond of butter and he steals the butter makhan, venna. Is he not rich enough to have butter in his house? Why should he not take milk? Why should he not drink curd? Why should he not go to ghee? Why should he be fond of this butter? Many people find fault with Krishna for being a thief of butter. Navaneeta chora. Navaneeta is butter. Chora means thief. He steals butter. He goes to the houses of the gopis and he climbs up. There is plenty of butter hoarded and he steals it, takes it. Similarly, there is another word, Manini Chitta Chora. Manini is a good girl, a pure girl, a perfect person, and that perfect person's mind is stolen. On one side, butter is stolen, and another side, the pure heart of a pure person is stolen. This is how we describe Sri Krishna. We shall try to see the significance of it. It is just our Patanjali Yoga Sutras. You have Ashta Anga Yoga. The last is Samadhi. The purpose of practicing yoga is to keep cool always, and it is always to keep our minds tranquil, serene, devoted, and finally we would like to have that total absorption in divinity. That's called samadhi. If you take Patanjali steps and Manini Chitta Chora and Navaneeta Chora, they are parallel, identical. The cow goes round, takes grass, assimilates, digests, and gives milk. By that time, there is a purification. Whereas we people go round the worldly activities, make a synthesis and produce a product, and this milk is further purified by boiling it in tapasya. When you boil the mind, when you burn the articles, the impurities are removed. The impurities in the milk are removed. Milk is boiled and then a drop of buttermilk is dropped in it. A thought of God is dropped in it. And then you keep it steady. When you keep it steady, it becomes curled. It gets curdled. Mind becomes tuned to the path of divinity. And then you churn it. You make a study of it. You make an introspection. You make a swadhyaya. You make an examination. And that's how you begin to have the Sankhya Yoga. When the whole buttermilk is churned, all butter is accumulated. Once the butter is produced, you make a ball of it. You try to put the butter in water, it does not get mixed. Butter will remain separate. The ball of butter, if you put it in water, it will float, it will not get mixed. You try to take that butter and put it in buttermilk, it will not get mixed with the buttermilk. You take that butter and put it in milk, it does not get mixed with it. It remains the same. Similarly, we people, when we accumulate that butter by the purification process, once the mind is given to God, once the mind is purified, once the mind is divinized, once the mind is ennobled, once it is offered to the Almighty, it does not come back to the world. There is a difference between the bee and the fly. The fly, eager, it goes to the dirt, it goes to gulab jam, it goes to rasgulla, it goes to excreta, world for some time, God for some time, ordinary fly. Whereas the bee, it will never go to the worldly things, it goes to flowers. It takes the drop of honey. The bee collects only the honey. The fly eats gulab jam, eats rasgulla, and also sits on the dirt and excreta. Ordinary people's minds are not pure. They go to God in Maitri Milan for some time. They go to God in bhajan for some time. And while doing the bhajan, they will be looking this side and that side for a beautiful girl. Ordinary man's mind. Sometimes we go to Mount Kailas and sometimes we go to the street ditch water. The extremes, ordinary people. Whereas the bee-like mind, it will never come down to the world. It always flies on the flowers, collects only the bee. Similarly, once you make the butter, your mind, that butter does not go to the world. You take Mirabai, she does not come down to the world at all. Always Krishna, 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 Krishna. You go to Prahlad, he never comes to the world at all, Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. You take any great devotee, Adi Shankaracharya, Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Vallabhacharya, Swami Narayan, Suraras, Tyagaraj, Ramadas. You take any number of great devotees, they always soar in the divine heights of devotion. Similarly, from the grass, the cow makes it milk. That milk is purified by getting boiled and it is steadily kept in tapasya. It becomes curd and then it is churned. Finally, the butter is produced. The earlier ones, with water it won't mix. With milk it won't mix, with buttermilk it won't mix, and it is tender. Put it on the tongue, it melts. It has a wonderful taste, divine taste. It is not hard for digestion. Ghee may be hard for digestion. Butter is simple, very tender, very soft, very sweet. And this divine Sri Rama Nama, divine Sri Krishna Nama, divine Namah Shivaya, anything, when you go to a particular height, your mind becomes better. And for that, there are seven steps. Yogava system of Vasishtha Maharshi, Sapta Bhumika, there are seven steps to go to that. Samadhi you leave, earlier there are seven steps. What are they? Be disciplined. Cow does not eat everything, be disciplined. Be principled, it is herbivorous. And then it is settled, asana. It is settled in a particular place to make it milk. Then it takes grass, gives milk to the society. It takes less from the society, it gives more to the society. It takes less valuable things from the society, it gives more precious things to the society. And then it eliminates whatever is not needed. All the impurities are removed, and dharana, the entire milk is full of butter. When dharana takes place, then you come to that divine jnana, single-minded devotion. From the butter, from the buttermilk, you have produced that butter. Navanita there, Chitta purified here, and then the girl, having served her all domestic duties, offered her mind, and then waits for the husband. The room is kept clean, the food is kept ready, the entire house is made excellent, butter is produced. Through pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, we purify ourselves, keep ourselves ready. If the house is dirty, husband does not come home. You love him, but you don't keep the house clean. I love God, but I don't keep the environment pure. What is required for the husband is Griha Lakshmi, not a dirty house. Many girls spend a lot of time on the physical makeup, keeping the room dirty, under the bed, beneath the cot, at the entrance, in the sofa set, clothes everywhere, glasses everywhere, pen everywhere, mobile everywhere. The home is dirty. God comes, sees, goes away. Lakshmi comes, sees chichi, dirty house, she goes away. People come, God comes there, looks at Maitri Milan, Mangal Mandir, at the entrance when the chappals are put like a dirty nonsense, Lakshmi comes, chi, these people don't have discipline, let me not enter, she goes back. Sri Krishna does not come to a person who is not pure. Purity and devotion, two things. Purity is physical purity, psychic purity, environmental purity. Many girls come and ask me, sir, my husband is not coming home direct from the office, sir. He is going to his secretary's house, sir. Why? That secretary keeps the house clean. She gives him coffee. As soon as your husband comes, you keep your house dirty, you quarrel with him. No milk, go to the shop, take a cup of tea and bring me tea. Who comes to such a dirty wife? Why does God not come to us? we are neither pure nor devoted. If you are devoted, you have to be pure. If you have to be pure, you should culminate in devotion. When purity and devotion are put together, that is dhyana. You may make the bed, you cannot get the sleep. Then you may raise the question, alright sir, I have prepared butter, why can't Krishna come and take it? Why should he steal it? You do not know when you slip into sleep. Common experience. Can anyone tell me exactly at 9:40, 9:03 seconds I slept, sir? Keep a stopwatch. What time did you sleep? If you press the stopwatch, you have not slept. If you sleep, you cannot press the stopwatch. Potassium cyanide, the taste of cyanide. One scientist wanted to find out. He kept cyanide on his tongue and he took the pen in his hand. He tried to see the taste. Yes, not completely. We do not know whether it is sour or salty or sweet. Even today. What is theft? When something happens without my knowledge, it is called theft. I have a note in my pocket. Somebody comes in the bus stand, he takes it away. I come home and find my pocket is cut. I call it theft because it has happened without my knowledge. How does sleep take place? Without my knowledge. How does a samadhi take place? Without my knowledge. Praying is my duty. Purifying is my duty. Loving is my duty. When Krishna comes and takes me, I do not know. When sleep comes and takes me, I do not know. When the thief comes and takes me, I do not know. When anything happens without my knowledge, it is called theft. My duty is to keep the environment clean, body, mind, intellect, equipment pure, and offer myself keeping the door open. When he comes, I do not know. I go to the bed, spread the bed, lie down on the bed. I do not know when I sleep. Ordinary experience sleep we are unable to remember when we fall. Young boys, you ask, when did you fall in love with that girl? I don't know, sir. Is it when she was in the library? I don't remember, sir. Is it when she is in the dining hall? I don't remember, sir. I do not know when, but somehow I fell in love. When we do not know. Similarly, Chitta Chora, Chora, he steals my mind. I do not know when. I slip into sleep. I do not know when. It is our duty to meditate. Dhyana tak, it is our responsibility. Once we are absorbed in meditation, he comes and takes away the mind, and that is samadhi. Rukmini in Bhagavata says, Krishna, Purushottama, Jagadishwara, Jagannatha, Jagannayaka, Dhanyun, Loka, Manobhiramun, Kula, Vidya, Rupa, Tarunya, Saujanya, Sri, Bala, Dana, Shaurya, Karunasam, Sobitun. Your qualities are excellent. You have excellent features, very handsome personality. You are a Jnani, you are the God of Gods, Krishna. I am pure, I am principled, I am disciplined, I am settled in my devotion. I go to the temple of Gauri, sit in meditation there. Krishna, please come, take me away without my knowledge. Our duty is to purify ourselves. Our duty it is to divinize ourselves. Our duty is to be absorbed in meditation. When we enter into samadhi, it is in his hands. Having come to prashanti, let us observe three things. Let us purify ourselves, let us ennoble ourselves, let us divinize ourselves and let us sit in meditation. Lord Krishna comes, takes away butter. Lord Krishna comes, takes away Rukmini. Lord Krishna comes and takes away into Samadhi. May we all by the grace of God Almighty attain the highest state of Samadhi, which is wonderful. Even if you taste that Samadhi for half a second, all other worldly pleasures appear to be nothing. May we go to the feet of the Almighty, meditate on that Supreme Paramatma and try to experience that Samadhi by His grace.